What's going on, Columbus?
Columbus, Ohio.
Yeah.
Columbus, Ohio.
I'm here with the Kottonmouth Kings of Orange County, the hip-hop punk rock band. What's up, y'all?
Southern Cali in your area. What's up, Ohio? Been a long time since we've been to Columbus. About, what, 6 months?
Yeah, it's been about since like October, right?
We're here at the ICP, yep. We're back.
First question I want to ask is, where's the best chronic on a tour?
In my chest.
In your chest?
About last month and a half.
Well, the best chronic is through the FedEx, and that's, you know what I mean?
What about United Pot Smugglers?
United Pot Smugglers?
UPS, man.
Okay, yeah, you know, it's all about shake and bag, and I'll help, you know what I'm saying?
Okay, one more. In the song...
I'm trying to figure out why... Everything is so brown out here in the middle of the country, man. It's hard to get chronic out here in these parts.
I don't know either, man. I couldn't answer that one.
I've actually been praying for you guys out here. I said, God bless the Midwest, Lord. Take away the stress. You know,
yeah.
We need to see some more kind buds out here, so bring the kind bud to the show.
Hell yeah, man. All right. In the song Suburban Life, you guys are basically saying, fuck the American dream. You guys want to elaborate on that a little bit for me?
Daddy X?
Oh, no, you know, well, basically, you know, we are brought up in a system where we're brainwashed to believe, first of all, America as a country has only been here 200 years, you know, and it's as long as we first acknowledge that this country was stolen from the Native American people who had occupied this land.
Stolen.
Thousands and thousands of years, and the, you know, the new colonists came over and took over this country by massacring the biggest genocide. Talk about ethnical cleansing that they claim that they are so opposed in Kosovo. That's how this whole country was taken over. You know, at first we got to acknowledge that this country is built on lies and blood of the Native American people, and that, you know, we're all put here and supposedly to conform to the big machine, you know, and we're just saying that it's all about our purpose for living, and we all have a reason for being here on this planet, and we don't believe it's, you know, necessary to have to work a 9-to-5 to pay all your taxes and you live in credit and in debt to try to fulfill the illusion of ownership in America. And we just believe that, you know, we're trying to attain freedom, you know what I mean, as individuals in our time here in this lifetime. That's it. That's basically about it.
Hell yeah, man. That was great, dude. What do you think of taxes, you guys? What do you guys think of that shit?
They're stealing.
Stealing.
Corporate management. Where's the corporate?
Daddy, yeah? Well, you know, any society, you know what I mean, you want to have roads and you want to have certain things. We believe there should be a flat tax, but just the way the taxes are in America, it's pretty much stealing. You know what I mean? They take 33% of your income, but if you make, they tax you for making money. They tax you when you live. They tax you when you die. They tax you when you sell. They tax you when you buy. They don't stop taxing you, you know what I mean? So taxes basically are stealing, yeah.
Definitely. Saw that on the inside inlet of the CD too, man. That's great. What's the word that best describes the Kottonmouth Kings philosophy?
Anarchy.
Same dog.
Anarchy.
Anarchy. You guys are the anarchists of rap. Is that correct?
Pretty much.
I'd have to say so.
Hell yeah. I heard a great song by Dial 7 called People. Now, you guys were on that track, is that correct?
Yeah.
You guys like Dial 7 and shit?
So hard every day, just in my reputation. What is that song?
No, that shit was all true, kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, Dial 7 is my peeps. What's up, Mike Lord, Clammers, Barrett? What up, homeboy? What up, all the fellas from Dial 7 camp? Big D Rock, the roadie. Motherfucker, I want to be rock and roll roadie. Then all the girls want to know me just so they can meet my homie. Maybe they would even want to blow me. That would be just fine. I don't think I'd mind.
Yeah. Have you guys been working on new material?
Yeah, sure. We're always working on new material, man. Every day everyone's writing, you know what I mean?
Hidden Stash comes out in
the week, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Drop some Suburban Noise, you know what I'm saying?
Hell yeah, man. That's tight.
It's probably one of those ones you're going to have to try and get over the internet, you know what I mean? Obviously, like, there's a lot of politics involved trying to get music out there, you know what I mean? Definitely trying to get it. Something on the radio and stuff like that, stuff we don't worry about, but definitely trying. We get directly to the people. So internet, cottonmouthkings.com, suburbannoise.com. Check out the new Too Rude record. Too Rude's here playing with us tonight. Columbus is Dog Boy, who you might have heard on that track, Dog's Life. He's an old school, like, reggae punker, you know. He's on Discombobulated on the record. Yeah, there's Dog Boy on there. He sings for a punk band called War Call Peace, so he's like roots to the core from the South Bay. And their band's out with us. They have a record coming out. It's done. It's real nice. Graham Vernacular, who's been on tour with us a couple times, he's like a lyrical scientist. He has a record coming out. And then DJ...
Compilation?
DJ Bobby B, our DJ, has a record, 99 Rips Beyond, which is an amazing instrumental journey to a stoner's paradise. You know, it's
Suburban Noise is pumping out some
a lot of stuff coming out of Suburban Noise in the future, you know. That compilation is going to be the shit. You guys are going to want to get a hold of that. It's going to have Corporate Avenger, a lot of artists, Suburban Noise artists.
Pakalika is going to drop some skills, mad
dancer.
Skills for y'all.
Grand Vernacular.
Johnny Richter, my dog.
Big Hoss USA.
Big Hoss is, we're going to drop some tracks from him.
U.S.
You know,
still the same. Shit coming right out of the joint. He
shit
recorded
coming
shit
right
in the joint.
Yeah.
He recorded shit in the joint.
Yeah, it's called Things Are Still the Same. That song, Big Hoss, that's my brother. He's getting out in about a couple months here. But when he gets out, yeah, he recorded some stuff right on a mini disc right in the joint.
Like four track.
Like a four track style. But yeah, we're gonna drop that on the Suburban Noise compilation. The song's called Things Are Still the Same. Because you know. It's like P-Town ballers get the ball rolling, fool step up, act crazy, get your head stolen. Then what does he say? Fucking get your head stolen. Get the steam. Wait, yeah, put the green to the bean, get the steam rolling. Oh fuck, now I'm dusted and my eyes are swollen. But homeboy plays guitar and sings, and he got his punk rock shit. It's kind of like it goes all over the road, you know?
He wrote a song about saying shit. It's pretty tight, you know? There's a lot of love in the fucking this organization, you know? It's dope.
It's definitely a family
organization, yeah. Suburban Noise, you know what I mean?
And the definitely. The cool thing about it,
it's like really raw. It's coming straight from like just like rough as you can get it, you know? And yeah, it's, that's what's dope about it, you know?
There's no drums.
It's straight
there.
From it's a cell block, so you know, there ain't no studio in a cell block, so it's all good, you know what I mean?
Yeah,
it's really live. What's up, Hoss?
Oh yeah, man. What's up? How'd you guys land a spot on the Lost and Found soundtrack?
Bowls with David Spade one day, and fucking came over, had a big barbecue in the Hollywood Hills.
Is he cool and shit? Does he smoke, man?
He takes all those funny looking pills.
He skates.
Hills, so I don't know. He had us up for three nights on fucking ecstasy, and as you know, hit the GHB. I felt fucking walking on the moon. I couldn't understand it. Ladies all over the place. That guy loves beautiful women. It's crazy.
Brad had an interesting night.
He's a little guy, man. He sure pulls a lot of.
Yeah, Matt.
Voluptuous women.
He's a funny little worm.
Who are some of you guys' favorite bands to tour with?
Alcoholics for me, D-Lo.
Alcoholics.
You know, we really love touring with the Suburban Noise bands the best because it's just our family and friends,
yeah,
you know what I mean?
I've been liking this tour the best.
This is the best tour.
Because
no
this is
about.
Our first, this is our first, Cottonmouth Kings, our first tour across the country where we main stage.
Suburban Noise,
you know?
Put it on,
yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Like,
it's the
like
shit.
A family.
We got Too Rude, Dog Boy, everybody, you know.
Everything that we've been talking about doing for like the past year, we just finally, like this tour, we put it together. Like all the bands, we like all our friends are together in the same buses.
Yep.
Everybody's getting high. It's all local love. Plenty of bud,
goals.
You know.
It just set some goals and fucking stuck to it. Here we are, you know what I mean?
Hell yeah.
Cottonmouth Kings, you got to see check out the back draft. Our logo is huge. Our boy Marcus Parker the Drunk hooked that
Marcus
shit
the
up.
Drunk made us his back jock and shit. It's
big backdrop, KK in the crown.
Drunken club.
You guys prefer a bong, a zong, or a bowl?
Zong.
A bong. Anything glass. You know, over a foot, you know, that is some good water in it, some Avion in the bung. So
we spill that shit all the time. I get it all over. It fucking stinks, man.
Zong's been kicking the Cottonmouth Kings down some nice glass, so we got to give it up. But Bobby, you can tell
Zong, me. Yeah, Zong has been kicking it. We got these boys in San Diego, Classic Hits. They make us personal pipes. They give us, like, road bongs and
nice.
Stuff. It's pretty cool. You know, we just bought a little piece right here across the street. What's the name of that little store?
Import House.
Import. They gave us a deal. We've been to Import in Columbia. They got good glass over there, you know. Good clean glass.
Hell yeah. What's your favorite brand of papers?
Orangies, 1 3/4.
Zigzaggies.
Yeah, but Bobby B the other night, we're driving. He just cleaned out the bong at the Zong. Smashed right in his hands for some reason. Glass everywhere, but you know, million pieces.
That
so
fucking sucks.
Need to send us another one, man. Ours broke.
Papa Steve, yeah, you know, help us out, baby.
Pop, what up? Oh, I need to get to the pharmacy, homie. No.
My fault, man. Oh, I already asked you that one. Okay. How'd you guys think of using Pakalika's fat ass breakdancing moves in your shows and your music?
He was there from the beginning. That goes way back to it. That was Brad X's. Brad X used to hang with Pac Lika.
Brad X.
AGN. He used to put on clubs and shit in Hollywood. And anyway,
like an old school breaker. He's just been around forever and shit. But you know, he's known Brad through the clubs in L.A. for like the past 10 years. And
you know, and it's like he was down with the Kottonmouth Kings. He liked what we were all about. And ever since the first show when Brad X came down, Brad X still in Humble Guys, we was busting shows, backyard parties, and just little house parties and shit. And Pac would always come and bring a joint, smoke us out, smoke out the Young Bucks. Him and X would roll through, you know, with the old school players coming through with the new school pimps, you know what I mean? We just putting this shit down.
Hey, Pac just loves busting for the people, you know what I'm saying? He'll bust, he just, that's his shit, you know? He just wants to bust in front of everybody.
It's a way of life.
He wants to let it be known, you know what I mean? He's been living that hip-hop life for all his life, and he's like originator of the art, you know what I'm saying?
He's
an originator, straight up.
He's down for heart. He's seen some heart in the Kottonmouth Kings.
He's been popping his whole life.
He's put the last 5 years of his life into it, you know? He's quit doing everything he's doing, and now he's just Kottonmouth Kings full out, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah. And if y'all don't believe it,
come see it.
This is,
I heard that you just became a daddy like a month or two ago there, boy or girl?
Daddy X in effect, little baby girl, man. Been blessed for sure. That's to have awesome. This beautiful youth brought forward for sure, you know.
Definitely, so definitely. Hell yeah, man.
Yeah, let it be known.
All right, y'all. Got something else to say for it.
The girl, her name's Sky Blue, and she's named in the memory of our late friend Rob Harris, who died. He's a skydiver. He died in a skydiving accident. So, you know, blue skies forever, you know what I mean? So hopefully.
DJ Rob Harris from the from the album, right?
Yeah, exactly. DJ Rob Harris.
Your inspiration.
Inspiration and
dedication,
baby.
Hell yeah, man.
Sure.
Hell yeah. Well, you guys got something else to say, all you guys?
Yeah, I don't know. If I could change the world. If I could change the world, because I've been on tour and shit, and I see the way all these girls act and all these people act out here on the road, it's funny. But if I could change the world, first I'd change myself. No more foolish vengeance, no more seeking wealth. I'd build one big utopia where we could all be free. No 9-to-5 to stay alive, just peace through anarchy. Hey, no groupie hoes to jock the flows of song and poetry. No icons, we'd all live long in love, not misery. It's just no groupie hoes to jock the flows of song and poetry. No icons, we'd all live long in love, not misery. Ladies, keep your clothes on, you know what I'm saying? Quit disrespecting yourself like that.
Yeah.
Kottonmouth Kings.
Yeah.
What's up, right ass?
Hell yeah.
And we out of here.
This is a Kottonmouth Kings interview. Newport Music Hall. Peace the fuck out. Yeah.
Keep it real, baby.
Here we go.